everybody. Oh, it's such an honor to be back at TEDx Thessaloniki. It's I love Thessaloniki. You're all amazing. If I could, I would have sex with all of you. But we don't have enough time, so. As you can see, there's a slight difference from 7 years ago. I'm not standing up. I'm now sitting down. I got tired of standing up. Fuck that shit. As you were told, I fell very ill in Malaysia 2 years ago in 2016. And now it's affected my movement, so I can't walk very well. My eyesight, so I can't see very well. And my speech. So I talk like I'm drunk. Actually, do you know what? I talk like I'm drunk, but I'm pretending to be sober. Very slowly and carefully. No, I didn't have anything to drink. I'm fine. I was in Malaysia for shows and with a group of comedians in April 2017. And one day I felt very ill, throwing up diarrhea, the usual, you know. And I was rushed to hospital because we all thought I had food poisoning. It turns out I didn't have food poisoning. Yay! I was dying. Boo! I had intestinal perforation, a hole in my bowels, or the αίσθηση εντέρου. Pick your choice, whatever. And all hell broke loose. When I say hell, I mean shit. All the shit broke loose from that little hole in my bowels. And my whole system got infected, and I got septicemia. And then I went into septic shock. Now, 8 out of 10 people who get septic shock die. I'm one of the people who survived. I don't know who the other one is. Thank you. Thank you. I don't think they're as good looking as I am. The doctors in Malaysia acted super quick. And they put me in an artificial coma to save my life and stabilize my condition. They kept me in a coma for 2 weeks. And when they woke me up, I was paralyzed from the neck down. Party! I couldn't even do this. And I didn't have any voice because my lungs were full of fluid. So I had a massive tube. You know the tube at the dentist which sucks out the saliva? A bigger tube that went much deeper. And it came out of my mouth. And over here, there was a little valve so the nurses could take the fluid out of my lungs. And this tube, though it wasn't painful, it stopped my vocal cords from working. So I woke up and I was like, hi guys, where's my voice? And my entire family surrounding my bed said, ha, you can't speak! This is brilliant! And that's when I realized I had the beginnings of a new comedy show. The moment when I was sure was with the nurses in Malaysia. The nurses in Malaysia were amazing. They were super cute and super effective, very quick to react, but they didn't speak English very well. So there was sometimes a lack of communication, which was hilarious. Whenever they heard, like, my lungs rattling with fluid, or they heard me coughing, one of them would run up and say, Katerina, you want me to suck you? Very high level of service. It And of course, all I wanted was to reply in the appropriate way that you would in a porn video. Yeah, bitch, suck me now. I didn't. I was very polite. Plus, I had no voice. So. My other favorite moment was in hospital in Greece. I've been to so many hospitals, guys. It's amazing. Hospitals rock. Yay. Kind of. In Greece, after my final operation, where they removed 30 centimeters from my intestine, there's miles of it in there. Don't worry, 30 centimeters is nothing. The doctor came up to me and said, you are now ready to perform all bodily actions, and we want you to perform a bowel movement. Να ενεργηθείτε. As soon as possible. And I was like, oh, it's up to me. It doesn't happen naturally. And they said, no, but just let you know, because we've removed part of your intestine, until it gets used to it, things will move very fast. And you won't have time to do anything. What we're saying is, Ms. Vrana, Κυρία Βρανά, you're going to have to learn how to shit yourself. Αχ, really. The dream come true. So the time comes. By the way, it's super fast. My doctors were not joking. Please pay attention. This is how fast it is. I think I want to... So out it comes. Yes, I shattered myself. Let's tick that off the bucket list. And it wasn't as disgusting as I thought it would be, because the bed was full of diapers that were sucking everything up, so it was fine. But when you're paralyzed from the neck down, someone else has to wipe you. Ah. So in come two nurses, a female nurse and male nurse. And I'm like, why is the gentleman here? Yeti. And the female nurse said, Katerina, you're paralyzed from the neck down. In order to wipe you, someone has to move you to the side, hold you there, while I gently stroke your bum. So the male nurse comes, grabs me, holds me like this. I'm like, hey. The female nurse is wiping my ass. And the situation is very hashtag awkward. And then the male nurse says, I've seen all your clips online. I'm a massive fan. You really should choose your moments better. So I said, I think now is the, allow me to introduce my butt and some of my shit. We're now best friends forever. Magic. And since September 2017, I'm in recovery and rehabilitation. I do physio every day. It's so fucking boring. I hate exercise, and now I exercise every day, sometimes twice a day. Thank God my physios are gorgeous. They're very good looking. So I pass the time by sexually harassing them. You know, I'm like, oh, I've got no balance, health. Oh, no, hold me. When I'm sitting down, I'm like, oh, what am I holding? I can't see. A If I wasn't in a wheelchair, they would have sued me. They're very wonderful, patient men. But living between the UK and Greece, I've noticed there's an amazing lack of awareness when it comes to disability in Greece. It's amazing because in Greece, we're kind of scared of illness, disabilities, psychological issues. All of these things are kept hidden in the closet, you know, with grandma's wedding dress and a gay uncle or two. And it's astounding. I went to a shopping mall in this little wheelchair, and three separate people bumped into me. They didn't see the wheelchair. Okay, fine. But my hair? They didn't see my hair. Three separate people. Do you know, not one of them said, I'm sorry, or excuse me, or can I have an autograph? I don't know what this country is coming to. But even though it's been tough, like not being able to see sucks balls. I mean, when you're ill, one of the things that are amazing to do is watch TV series and movies. I can't do that. I can't even read books. I have to listen to audiobooks. Let me tell you that if your favorite book is read by someone whose voice you do not like, it stops being your favorite book. But more or less, I am having a good time. The show I've made out of this experience, which is called Staying Alive, in brackets, I nearly died, you know, is my favorite show so far. The response has been amazing. And if there's one thing I've learned, of course, there's a didactic message in this speech. Pay attention, bitches. If there's one thing I've learned is there's a very old Chinese proverb that says, you are not what happens to you, you are how you deal with it. And that's so true. You want to clap or not? Yes, the Chinese are very wise. We're applauding them. I think you can deal with anything. If you have love, respect, and laughter in your life, you have to be able to laugh with stuff, because life is full of shit. I should know. I had most of it. But at the same time, life is full of rainbow unicorns as well. And the unicorns make the shit smell less, and the shit makes the unicorn shine more. And there's a saying, when life gives you lemons, make lemonade. That is one of the worst sayings I have ever heard. I'd like to change it into, when life gives you shit, make manure. In Greek, it sounds amazing. Όταν η ζωή σου δίνει σκατά, κάνε κομπριά. Manure, it's true, manure is amazing. It's a creative force and a force for growth and new stuff. I mean, I've never been more beautiful the now. And I want to say something in Greek. Στην Ελλάδα έχουμε αυτό το νύκτο και αυτό το τη λύπηση προς αρρώστους, τους ταμέα ή τα άτομα ψυχολογικά προβλήματα. Κανείς δεν χρειάζεται εκτοκή λύπηση. Είναι άχρηστα συναισθήματα. Και κρύβουν και ένα ψεύτο συνέστημα ανωτερότητας. Ξέρετε αυτό το «αχ, το καημένο». Πάλι καλά, εγώ είμαι καλύτερα. Πώς μεγάλη πουστιά. Αυτό που χρειάζεται ο κόσμος δεν είναι εκτογκελίπηση, είναι κατανόηση και πρακτική βοήθεια. Όταν μένα με βλέπετε στον δρόμο να προσπαθώ να περπατήσω, δεν θέλω να σκεφτείτε, αχ, η καμένη κοπέλα, τι έπαθε. Θέλω να σκεφτείτε, αχ, η καμένη μονάρα. Thank you so much. Έλα. Τι τέλεια! Θα βάλω τα κλάματα.
Εγώ τα έχω βάλει ήδη.
Θα τα βάλω και βάστηκα. Ευχαριστώ πάρα πολύ. Thank you. Όλα καλά.
Όλα καλά.
Όλα θα... Η νοσοκόμη φωνή, θα φύγω ή θα κάνουμε κι ο ναι.
Εδώ είμαστε, εδώ είμαστε.
Εδώ, εδώ. Ναι, ρε φίλοι, ναι!
Δεν σε αφήνω, όχι, λίγο να τη βλέπει κι ο κόσμος, ο κόσμος.
Το στήθος μου, κυρίως. Παιδιά, ο παρέμνηστητο μετά από το ασταλιπωρή είναι αξιοθαύμαστο.
Η εμπειρία και το τι έχει ζήσει είναι μοναδικό, απερίγραπτο. Και το περιγράφεις με έναν τρόπο που επίσης είναι ανεπανάληπτος.
Ευχαριστώ πολύ.
Από πού παίρνεις όλη αυτή τη δύναμη?
Από το στήθος μου.
Τέλεια. Τέλεια. Όλοι οι υπόλοιποι τι θα κάνουμε?
Έχω αρκετό για όλους.
Για τα...
Αλλά σοβαρά, νομίζω η δύναμη μου έρθει από το χιούμορ και την καφροσύνη της οικογένειάς μου. Παιδιά, η οικογένεια μου είναι τρελή κάφρη. Οι φίλοι μου και... Δεν μου αρέσει να ακούμε σε κάποια ντίβα, ξέρει, η αγάπη του κόσμου. Αλλά μαλάκα η αγάπη του κόσμου, είστε θεοί, σοβαρά θα σας πείδαγα αν μπορούσα. Μην αγχώνεστε οριζόντια, κάνω θαύματα.
Νομίζω ότι μετά από τόσους μήνες έχεις κάνει πολύ πρακτική στο οριζόντιο.
Ναι, στο οριζόντιο πάρα πολύ καλή. Δεν σου λέω τίποτα.
Μετά έχει να μας δώσει tips, να ξέρετε.
Stay tuned.
Αυτό που είναι πάρα πολύ σημαντικό και λόγω του TEDx, ας πούμε, είναι ότι πέρα από τη θεωρία περνάμε στην πράξη. Το γεγονός ότι με τη ζωή σου δείχνεις έμπρακτα ότι ό,τι και αν μας συμβαίνει, πρέπει να βρούμε τη δύναμη ή αν ναι. καταφέρουμε να βρούμε τη δύναμη, μπορούμε να απολαύσουμε πράγματα μεν με διαφορετικό τρόπο.
Αυτό είναι.
Και για ανθρώπους που βρίσκονται σε δύσκολη συνθήκη, που έχουν όχι απαραίτητα αντιμετωπίσει το θάνατο, αλλά που στην καθημερινότητα έχουν πάρα πολλές δυσκολίες. Και η Ελλάδα δεν είναι μια εύκολη
αυτό.
Χώρα στην οποία είναι όλα προσβάσιμα για όλους.
Όχι μόνο αυτό. Δεν είμαστε και ανοιχτοί σε προβλήματα ψυχολογικού είδους ή σε δυσκολίες. Δηλαδή, το μόνο που αναγνωρίζουμε είναι το χωρισμό και την καψούρα. Δεν δεχόμαστε άλλες δυσκολίες. Όλα μας τα τραγούδια είναι που τα αναμάφησε ο Πούτσης με κεράτωσε.
Άρα τι είναι σημαντικό να αρχίσουμε να βλέπουμε στην καθημερινότητα, σαν να τα έξουμε στην παλέτα μας, δεν ξέρω θα είναι.
Όχι, νομίζω ότι είναι πολύ σημαντικό να μην φοβάσαι, να μιλάς ανοιχτά και ειλικρινά, γι' αυτό περνάς. Έχουμε μία σοβαροφάνεια. Και ένα φοβό τσαλακώματος, που είναι τεράστια μαλακία, παιδιά. Θέλεις να μου πει τώρα το λεοπαρδαλέ μου, δε γαμμένο, είμαι σε καροτσάκι. Το τσαλάκωμα που φοβάται ο κόσμος δεν υπάρχει. Αν είσαι ειλικρινής με αυτά που περνάς και ανοίγεσαι. Η βοήθεια είναι εκεί, ο κόσμος θέλει να βοηθήσει. Απλώς δεν ξέρει πώς και δεν ξέρει να κάνει. Και αν δεν τους πεις, δεν μπορούν να μυρίζουν τα ανοίγια τους να μαντέψουν τι έχεις. Όσο πιο πολύ μιλάμε ανοιχτά για αυτά που μας ενοχλούν και αυτά που μας προβληματίζουν, τόσο πιο μέρος της καθημερινής μας ζωής θα γίνει και θα ενταχθεί τελείως νορμάλ στο κάθε μέρος, στο κανονικό. Αυτό έχει κατάσταση, αυτή σχεδόν πέθανε, αυτός μετακομίζει και αυτό πρόβλημα είναι. Και θα τα αντιμετωπίζουμε πιο εύκολα και χωρίς φόβο. Πρέπει να εξορκίσουμε αυτό το φόβο. Και το φόβο βαραίνει τα πάντα παραπάνω. Και είναι κρίμα. Πες μια μαλακία αν περάσει ώρα. Βρίζε ρε φίλε. Αυτό πιστεύω, ότι να είμαστε πιο ανοιχτοί και πιο ειλικρινείς με αυτό που έχουμε. Να λέμε το καρκίνο, καρκίνο και όχι το κακό. Όπως έχω πει και στην Άννα, έτσι και πάθω και καρκίνο, θα γίνω έξαλλη. Έξαλλη.
Κυρίες και κύριοι, Κατερίνα Βρανά.